Pro-democracy protests in Hong Kong have rolled into their 22nd straight week, and there are more violent outbreaks. Police fired tear gas at demonstrators during weekend protests. They arrested more than 300 people over the weekend. Police say four people were injured in a knife attack on Sunday. Two are in a critical condition. It happened in an area where protests had taken place earlier in the day. Amongst the injured is a pro-democracy politician. There are reports that his ear was partially bitten off. Now, during the past 5 months of protests, police have been accused of using excessive force. One journalist says they're even targeting the media, and she says her injury is proof. She spoke exclusively to our Anna Coren.
On a footbridge in Wan Chai, an Indonesian journalist following Hong Kong riot police streams live to her viewers on Facebook. Within minutes, officers raise their guns as a group of protesters appear. With police retreating, the crowd moves forward. Suddenly, an officer fires a shot. A rubber bullet has hit journalist Bibi Inder in her right eye. Her body slumped on the ground, crying out in pain, her camera still streaming. For more than 3 weeks, Vivi lay in this hospital bed. She underwent surgery twice, and while doctors managed to preserve her ruptured pupil, they were not able to save her eyesight.
I don't know what to answer. I don't know what would happen.
Her older sister flew in from Jakarta, refusing to leave her side, her reassuring presence most valuable at night when the flashbacks of the shooting haunt Vivi.
This will be a hard time for her.
39-year-old Vivi came to Hong Kong in 2012 working for an Indonesian newspaper. She mainly reported on labour issues affecting migrant workers. That was until the Hong Kong protest kicked off. Vivi has been on the front line many times and believes it's her job to document the truth. But now she fears that journalists are being targeted by police.
I pray, please God, no more journalists get shot. Because this is crazy, we're not in war zone.
VB's lawyer, Michael Vidler, plays video from a recent protest. He says the footage shows an officer throwing a tear gas grenade at a group of journalists.
Oh my God.
An exploding grenade.
It's this refusal to accept the fact that some officers are out of control is the problem, because then it gives them license to do even worse. And we are seeing an escalation of the misconduct of the police officers.
Since the shooting here on the 29th of September, Vivi has filed a complaint with police and provided them with a written statement. She is demanding to know the name of the officer who shot her so she can take civil action. Information the police to date have refused to reveal. When contacted by CNN, Hong Kong police said the case is under investigation and could not comment. The Hong Kong Journalists Association says police have, quote, repeatedly used unnecessary force against reporters, a claim police vehemently deny.
We certainly do not target a genuine reporter intentionally, and I would like to suggest that police fully respect the right of media to report an incident in Hong Kong.
We have seen individual operations that involved reporters standing in between the police officers in operations and rioters. I understand that those spots are easier for doing proper news coverage, but those are indeed dangerous spots.
If the officer was shot in the eye, he will not last 3 weeks in the hospital. Just watching and wondering what is happening. And why is this like this? Why this happened? Why does nothing happen?
The lack of answers now driving Vivi in her pursuit for justice. Anna Coren, CNN, Hong Kong. Of course.